Hi, I'm Paul Toole, Minister for Lands and Forestry in New South Wales. Thank you for joining this webinar as we explain how the management of Crown land in New South Wales is changing for the better. There are millions of hectares of Crown land across the state. It belongs to you, the people of New South Wales, and it supports significant social, environmental, and cultural benefits for every community. The old framework governing Crown land is complex and outdated, and you told us that it did not effectively meet your needs. We have listened, and the draft community engagement strategy that we're about to discuss in this webinar is a direct response to what you've told us. This engagement strategy lies at the heart of the new Crown Land Management Act, which will modernise the way Crown land is maintained and preserved in New South Wales. It reflects the need for more community involvement in decisions over Crown land, and better public understanding of how and why decisions are made. The strategy also recognises and supports Aboriginal involvement in Crown land, as well as reducing red tape and the administrative burden over Crown land management. The community engagement strategy creates a formal framework for us to work together. It is a starting point. It will evolve over time, and we want your involvement when refining it. The New South Wales Government wants to hear from you as a user, manager, or custodian of Crown land. Please tell us what you think. This will help ensure that when the new Act commences in 2018, the Community Engagement Strategy does its job by supporting meaningful community involvement in Crown land management, both now and into the future. Thank you for your time.
Hi, I'm David Clark. I work for the New South Wales Department of Industry in the Crown Lands and Water Division. I'm proud to work for the department that looks after Crown land across the state for the people of New South Wales. Crown land is land that is owned and managed by the state government on behalf of the people of New South Wales. The New South Wales Crown Land Estate is a vast network of more than 500,000 parcels of land covering around 34 million hectares, or some 42% of the state. Thousands of people from communities large and small across New South Wales enjoy Crown land every day of the year, whether it's for socialising, playing, keeping fit or simply relaxing at local parks and reserves, showgrounds and racecourses, community halls, camping grounds and a whole lot more. Given the vast nature of the Crown land estate, the department uses different ways to protect and manage this land in accordance with Crown land legislation. In many instances, the care, control and management of Crown land is delegated to a Crown land manager who has local knowledge and is best placed to manage the land. Crown land managers are either local councils or other incorporated organisations such as Scouts and Girl Guides. Crown land is also managed by dedicated local volunteers who are appointed to form a board, and we have some 700 of these boards across the state. The department also issues licences, permits and leases to individuals, businesses, clubs and other organisations who have responsibility for the land in line with the terms of their tenure, be it for farming, marinas, caravan parks, restaurants or kiosks. In response to feedback from the community for greater involvement in decisions about Crown land, the New South Wales Government has mandated a new community engagement strategy. The purpose of the strategy is to ensure that community input is actively sought and considered on the decisions that may affect the community about Crown land. A draft community engagement strategy has been developed and is now on public exhibition. The new strategy will support transparent and appropriate engagement with communities to develop a better understanding of how people use and value Crown land when making decisions. The community engagement strategy will be used by the people responsible for managing Crown land under the new Crown Land Management Act 2016. One important exception is local councils. Councils will not be required to comply with this strategy, as they will be required to comply with the Local Government Act 1993 when managing Crown land. Under the new Community Engagement Strategy, engagement about Crown land will occur where a proposed dealing or activity is likely to have a negative impact on current community use and enjoyment of Crown land. There are seven types of dealings and activities that fall within the scope of the community engagement strategy. Some Crown land dealings and activities are excluded, and these are identified in the draft strategy. Where an activity or dealing is within the scope of the strategy and impacts on current community use and enjoyment, we need to determine whether the likely level of impact will be minimal, moderate, or high. Once the level of impact has been identified, there are three engagement approaches: inform, consult, participate. For example, Crown land which is no longer required for public use can be sold. Under the strategy, all sales will be notified before they proceed, and the community will be able to make a submission on the impact of the proposed sale on their use and enjoyment of the land. We understand this is all new and can seem daunting, particularly for the people responsible for carrying out the engagement. To help understand and implement the community engagement strategy, we have also developed a comprehensive guidance and resources document. The documents are currently in draft, and we are seeking feedback from our stakeholders and the community to help us refine them. Feedback can be provided via a submissions process, which is outlined on our website and has the government's Have Your Say website. All submissions received will be made available to the public on the Crown Lands website unless otherwise indicated. All submissions will also be considered in the development of the final community engagement strategy. During the submission period, we will also be holding information sessions in Ballina, Wagga Wagga, Dubbo, Newcastle and Sydney. These informal sessions will allow you to find out more about the strategy and have your questions answered by our team. Please see the Crown Land website for more information. I encourage all interested people to please provide your feedback on the draft strategy. The final community engagement strategy will be formally adopted by the Minister for Lands and Forestry when the new Crown Land Management Act commences in early 2018. I hope you've enjoyed this webcast. Thanks for your time, and we look forward to hearing from you.